The ESP32 CAM is a tiny but powerful board that lets you capture images, stream live video, and even run basic computer vision, all for less than $10. In this video, we will build a simple and practical project, a camera on a breadboard that saves pictures to an SD card when you press a button. If you are just getting started with ESP32 CAM modules, this is the perfect place to begin, and once you understand the basics, you'll be ready to explore everything else this board can do. Let's dive in. The ESP32 CAM is a super affordable development board, usually priced around $10, that combines two powerful features in one package: a Wi-Fi and Bluetooth capable ESP32 chip and a built-in camera module. That means it can take pictures, stream live video, or even do basic computer vision tasks. It also has a micro SD card slot on board, which makes it perfect for saving photos. The board also features a very powerful white LED, which can act as a flash in low light conditions. You can turn it on through code right before capturing a photo to improve lighting indoors or at night. However, it does have some limitations. For example, there is no built-in USB port, so to upload your code, you'll need either an FTDI programmer or a small motherboard with an embedded USB to serial converter. I chose the second option, the little motherboard, because it makes our life so much easier. It handles the upload automatically, powers the port, and helps avoid common wiring mistakes. It is also worth noting that the ESP32 CAM has limited GPIO pins, and some are shared with the camera and SD card, so when you are adding buttons or sensors, you'll need to choose your pins carefully. But once you understand how it works, it unlocks a whole world of low-cost smart camera projects you can build right away. Now let's build our simple camera. We will be using just a few components: the ESP32 CAM module, the ESP32 CAM motherboard, a breadboard, a push button to trigger the photo, an SD card for saving the images, and some wires. The wiring is super simple. We connect 5 volts and ground to power the board, and then hook up the push button between GPIO 12 and ground. That's it. No extra resistors are needed. We will use the ESP32's internal pull-up resistor in the code. And since we are saving the photo to the onboard SD card, there is no need to add anything else. Let's power it on to see how it works. When the board boots up, it initializes the camera and the SD card. If everything goes well, the onboard LED will flash briefly. That's our signal that the system is ready. Before we go further, a crucial piece of advice for any project using SD cards: always make sure the board is powered off before you insert or remove the SD card. Removing it while powered on can easily corrupt your data and the card itself. Now, every time we press the button, the camera captures an image and saves it to the SD card as a JPEG file. The file name auto-increments so we don't override previous photos. The best part, the camera module itself handles the JPEG compression, so we don't need to process raw image data in our code. It is fast and efficient right out of the box. Here is how an image from this camera looks. I am using VGA resolution, that's 640 by 480 pixels, because it's a great balance between speed and image quality. It captures in just a fraction of a second, and the file size is small enough to save quickly to the SD card. As you can see, it is not high definition, but it is more than good enough for most basic projects. And remember, you can always increase the resolution later if you want sharper images. It can go up to 2 megapixels. Just be aware, it may slow things down a bit. Now that our hardware is ready and wired up, let's move on to the software. To program the ESP32 CAM, you need to install the ESP32 port support in the Arduino IDE. If you haven't done this before, just go to File, Preferences, and paste this URL into the Additional Board Manager URLs field. Then head over to the Board Manager by clicking here, search for ESP32, and install it. Next, you'll also need the eloquent ESP32 CAM library, which makes working with the camera and the SD card much easier. Click on the Library Manager here, search for eloquent ESP32 CAM and install it. Once that's done, select the ESP32 Dev module as your board type and choose the correct COM port. But before uploading the code, make sure to adjust two important settings in the Tools menu. Otherwise, the sketch may not work properly. Partition SIM, set it to Huge Up to ensure there is enough memory for the camera. And PSRAM, set this to Enabled. The ESP32 CAM includes built-in PSRAM, and the camera relies on it to function correctly. If you are using the small motherboard like I am, there's no need to unplug or rewire anything. Just keep the ESP32 CAM connected and hit Upload. The motherboard takes care of putting the board into a programming mode automatically, which makes things a lot simpler, especially for beginners. In this video, I won't go line by line through the code, just to keep things simple and focused. But don't worry, I have prepared a PDF with detailed comments explaining how everything works. You'll find the link in the description, so you can download it and follow along at your own pace. Now that everything is working, we can unplug the ESP32 CAM from the USB motherboard and place it back on the breadboard to test it on its own. And it works beautifully. We have just created a simple do-it-yourself camera. From here, the possibilities are endless. You could 3D print a custom enclosure, add a rechargeable battery, or even connect a small display to preview the captured images. Speaking of batteries, how long can this thing run on one? I hooked up a USB power meter and the ESP32 CAM draws around 130 milliamps while idle, with brief spikes during photo capture. That means if you use a standard 1000 mAh LiPo battery, you'll get roughly 7 to 8 hours of continuous operation, maybe a bit more if you add sleep modes during captures. So yes, it is very realistic to turn this into a portable, self-contained camera, perfect for outdoor or motion-triggered photo projects. And this is just the beginning. Stay tuned, because in one of the next videos, I'll attempt to build a complete camera with a 3D printed case, a rechargeable battery, and maybe even a small display to preview the photos. It will be a fun and useful project, and we will explore what this little board can really do. Thanks for watching, and if you found this helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with someone who might enjoy building their own smart camera. See you in the next one.